Morning. Fox 45 Morning News.
A quick thinking mom helps police make an arrest after her daughter is targeted on Facebook. Exactly what the mom did, that's coming up.
While wedding guests celebrate, the wedding photographer is fighting for his life after being robbed and attacked. We'll have the latest on that investigation.
And new details about who saw the Ray Rice video and when. The person, a new report says, the video was sent to first.
You're watching Fox 45 Early Edition. All local, all morning.
Good morning. On this Friday, September 26th, I'm Tom Rogers. Patrice Sanders has the morning off, but my goodness, we heard it. Jonathan Myers is possibly talking about sunshine for the weekend. Let's check in with him right away.
What's that big orange thing? That thing in the sky.
It hasn't been that long. I mean, we saw it just the
other
day.
Yeah, no, we actually had a few weeks of nice weather before that. Man, we had a little deluge, ugly day yesterday. Yeah. A lot of clouds actually on Wednesday, too. Right. So I think it's about time we go back to sun, right?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, let's do it. All right, let's try things out. And you see here, just in time for our weekend. Yes, yes, yes. We do have the clouds and showers now up toward New England, continuing to spin away off into the Atlantic, clearing skies moving in for us. BWI right now, you're at 56 degrees. We've got mainly clear skies, winds northwest at 3, humidity 97%, and our dew point at 55 degrees. Inner Harbor currently at 61. We've got 62 at Annapolis, 53 chilly ones at Westminster, and Columbia looking at 58 degrees this morning. Look at that bus stop forecast for today. We'll call it a perfect Friday. Pickup time, 57 degrees. Lunchtime, we're at 74 and lots of sun. And drop-off time, 78 degrees and ample sunshine in your forecast. How about that weekend? We'll talk all about it coming up in my Weather Authority forecast in a couple of minutes. Now, Candace Dolce with our traffic edge.
A purple perfect Friday, right?
Yeah, it's a perfect
Friday. We got the
Friday.
Double Let's combination do it. Here. All right, out on the roadways, we do have one accident, Duval Street, that's right at Garrison Boulevard, but really no incidents out along the JFX, and everything looks calm on 83, traveling just above that beltway, all the way on the southbound lanes, heading down through 695. Out of loop lanes of the beltway, from 95 up towards 83, 11 minutes, 55 miles per hour, only a 7-minute trip from 83 to 795, and then we'll take it on the west side, 795 up to 95. Now 11 minutes, only 55 miles per hour there. Let's look at your travels. Let's turn it back over to you.
Thank you, Candace. 5:02 is the time. And new this morning, an overnight fire in northwest Baltimore heavily damages a house. It happened just before midnight on Garrison Boulevard and Duval Avenue. Now, the fire is out now, and there's no word on any injuries, but we know that paramedics were on the scene. More details as they become available to us. And first on Fox this morning, a Baltimore man is behind bars this morning, charged with trying to have sex with a 14-year-old girl. And police credit a nosy mother with helping to crack that case. Amber Miller is at City Police Headquarters with more on this unusual story that you're seeing first on Fox, right, Amber?
That's exactly right, Tom. The mother, who does not want to be identified because she wants to make sure her daughter remains safe, discovered the suspect had contacted her daughter on Facebook. And that's when she went ahead and took matters into her own hands. She learned a 28-year-old man was sending obscene messages on Facebook to her 14-year-old daughter. So the mother started corresponding with the man, posing as her teenager.
And then he offered me weed, alcohol. He also sent me pictures of his genitals. And the whole time that we're talking, he think he's talking to my daughter, but he's really talking to me, Mom. So I'm at the police station setting him up, and he got caught.
That's right. 28-year-old Michael Henry was arrested in the parking lot of a donut shop on Dundalk Avenue, and he faces two charges, solicitation and attempted sex offense. We're live at the Baltimore City Police Headquarters. Amber Miller, Fox 45, Early Edition.
Thank you, Amber. Well, we're learning new details this morning about who saw the Ray Rice video and when. Now, according to the Associated Press, a law enforcement official has identified the specific NFL official he says that he sent that video to of Rice and his wife inside that New Jersey casino elevator. The report says it was sent to a league security chief named Jeffrey Miller. Miller denies ever receiving the video and says he never saw it until it was released online. And an NBA player is arrested on charges of domestic assault. Charlotte Hornets forward Jeff Taylor, seen right here, faces one count of domestic assault, one count of assault, and one count of malicious destruction of property after police were called to a Michigan hotel early Thursday morning. Taylor has been in the league for two seasons into his third year. A wedding photographer attacked and left unconscious in the street while the reception just went on. He is still fighting for his life. His family is holding on to hope, and police are looking for your help. Larry Collins is streaming live at Shock Trauma with a look at the story and what happened. And Larry, the latest details for us.
That's right. Good morning, Tom. Well, while they dined and danced in the reception, the man taking the pictures, he was being attacked and robbed, left unconscious on the street. It was Saturday night. Eric Saddam was working at the reception photo booth at the 1840s ballroom. For an unknown reason, he left the building. That's when someone on South Front Street hit him over the head, took his phone and his keys, and then left him severely injured. That was until police found him.
It's absolutely terrible. I mean, the people who did it are clearly cowards who have nothing good going on with their own lives, and so they have to take from somebody else. It's absolutely terrible.
It's horrible. I don't know why they would do such a thing. It's senseless. They didn't get anything worth anything. And he made, you know, we have to just hope that he makes it.
And police are looking for any information from anyone who may have seen something. They're also looking to see if there's a connection between this attack and any other attacks that have happened recently in that area. I'm Larry Collins, Fox 45 Early Edition.
Thank you, Larry. The woman who first recognized a man wanted in the abduction of a University of Virginia student is now speaking out. She says it was her call to authorities that ended that manhunt. Jesse Matthew was taken into custody after being found on a beach in Galveston, Texas. Karen, who asked that her last name not be used, was on that same beach, sitting on the tailgate of her SUV when she saw a car speed by and slam on his brakes into the sand. She says she recognized that man instantly, and they just stared at one another.
At a glance, I think I resemble Hannah. And I know that's why he double took at me. I do. And that's what made me know that was him.
Well, she says Matthew drove off going to a blue tent that he had pitched out on the beach. She then called the sheriff's office. Matthew is expected to be extradited back to Virginia today. Bed bugs invade the Naval Academy. Midshipmen in 34 rooms in Bancroft Hall have moved to other quarters. Those rooms will be closed for a month while they're being treated. You may recall 8 dorm rooms were affected in another outbreak back December 2012. Well, for the latest on new and developing stories, just like the ones we've been sharing with you so far this morning, don't forget to check out the Fox 45 Morning News app. Just search WBFF in your phone's app store to get started. And of course, that Morning News app is free. Coming up on the early edition, a powerful earthquake rattles Alaska, the magnitude of that quake, and the major event that was taking place when it hit.
And beautiful sunshine on the way for today. After the clouds yesterday, mostly sunny skies and temperatures getting up to 75 to 80 degrees at BWI. I'm liking what I see, and it continues into the weekend. We'll talk about when the next chance of rain is. Coming up next, time now 5:08. You're watching Fox 45 Early Edition.